Yeah. Hey, we're back. We're back for the marathon 2022. You know, actually, congratulations to everybody. It doesn't matter what race you participated in, you did it. And that's pretty awesome. It is a big deal. And so I hope you feel good about what you did, how you accomplished it, all the miles that got you there. Really, really cool. We're really happy with just participating. It was great.
It was nice to be back.
Right?
Yeah,
it really was. Yeah. It's different, but, you know, but we were able to do it with all of you. Really awesome. We have a lot of footage.
We have a lot.
And
we think it's going to be three videos worth of marathon stuff.
So,
or marathon weekend stuff.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, we try our best to post a video every week. So we're looking at, you know, 3 weeks out, we're going to have footage covering everything that we experienced at the marathon. This video is going to cover the day of the expo and then the day of the half marathon, because we wanted to go out and cheer the runners on. So stick around, watch. You might see yourself, and let us know what you think. Yeah, so we left.
We left our house at 2:30. No, we tried to leave by 2:30. We ended up leaving at 3 in the morning to get to the airport for a 6:10 flight.
Seriously, we were so excited. We were packing and everything, even though we had planned, you know, for like months to pack. And, you know, we only got like 2 hours of sleep. So we got on the road and we headed out to the airport. And we were really, really grateful. You know, if you've been watching, we were very concerned that our flight would get canceled. And it wasn't canceled. It was delayed. No big deal.
Our pilot overslept.
Yeah.
They never quite admitted that, but I am certain that's what happened.
That's what it was. That's what it was. So we sat on the plane.
For like an hour.
And all of a sudden over the intercom, he's like, hey, everybody, I just got here. So anyway, it was no big deal. You know, the flight... no hassles, nothing.
It was easy.
We landed. And then for the first time ever there for the marathon, well, even though this is our second one, but for the first time ever going to Disney World, we rented a car.
Right.
That was... We're not thrilled about driving. We're not thrilled about driving. But we'll do it. I mean, obviously, we do it. You know, in all the times that we've gone, we've only been on a bus to go from the airport to the resort.
Yeah, the Magical Express. Yeah. Getting rid of that made us rethink how we get around. And it had kind of a domino effect that we didn't use. We probably half and half for getting around the parks for the rest of our trip. We would use like our transportation versus Disney's transportation.
Yeah.
Pros and cons to each. I think we're leaning towards renting a car now in the future. It was really, really super convenient.
It was.
Yeah, so thanks to Magical Express and Omicron and not wanting to like sit on too many buses, we rented a car.
Yeah. Yeah, and I try to pay attention in years past of the route that the bus would take from the airport to the resort. And after a while, I would just get turned around. I'm like, I have no idea. And it really isn't that difficult. You know, and so anyway, that was great, because what we did is when we landed, with very little sleep, we got the rental car, we drove to the expo.
Yeah, straight to the expo, knocked that out. And this is, so Sunday was our race. This is on Friday. So we got there, it ended up being about midday, 11 or 12 on Friday. Went into the expo. So the expo, if you weren't there, if you were there, you know all of this, but if you weren't there, there's basically two stops you need to make, one optional stop you need to make on your expo trip. The first stop is going in to pick up your bib. So they have little like booths lined up around this room and you find your bib number range. We were towards the very end of the bib numbers. We're telling ourselves that they did it partially alphabetically. We're W's. Holy so, it was alphabetical, right? That's why our bib number was like 7,000 out of 8, or 7,700 out of 8,000.
That's it. We were back there.
So yeah, we go in, you find your little thing. I loved the digital waiver this year. not having to carry a sheet of paper with me mm-hmm. while traveling was great. Mm-hmm. So it was super easy. It was the fastest we've ever like checked in and out at one of these things. Mm-hmm. Showed them my ID, showed them our little, they had like a, you had to take a screenshot or something, whatever. Show them that, great, blah, 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 easy, here's your bib, great.
Great.
Stop one, done.
Right.
Okay.
Stop two.
The expo. And what they do is they put your race shirts at the very back of the building in the expo. So you have to walk through all the booths of vendors yeah. to get your t-shirts. Yeah. And they have to walk all the way back through them. Yeah. And for a couple of introverts, it's really kind of horrifying.
Yeah.
So we just kind of put our heads down and get through it as fast as we can, go get our shirts and get out.
Yeah. I don't know if you know this about us, but we really are big introverts. Really. What I mean by that is, we lose a lot of energy when we're around people, and so what we and I don't know, it's just hard for us, and when there's a lot going on, when it's frenetic and stuff, we kind of tend to either look for a dark corner or the exit.
So we found the exit,
right? We pick up our stuff and we kind of, but you know, you can see kind of, you know, what it's like from, you know, floor view of mm-hmm. all the things there. And there's a lot of really great stuff
there. I'm sure there are a lot of really great booths and merchandise and things like that.
But the third stop is optional.
So the other building that you kind of stop in on is the Run Disney race specific merchandise. And in years past, we like to buy a little coffee mug. We have a couple of coffee mugs from the Star Wars runs we used to do.
Yeah.
We tried to get a mug at the marathon 2 years ago. They were out, so we didn't get a mug, but we at least got a... and they didn't have the metal replica pins either by the time we got there, but we got at least a Marathon Weekend 2020 pin yep. that we put on our little pin board over here.
Yeah.
This year there was like nothing, nothing by the time we got there.
It was pretty sparse.
It was, slim pickings.
Well, and part of it is, you know, the rumor, and it's probably true, is that, there are supply issues. So, mm-hmm. you know, we have to deal with that in it every day now. Mm-hmm. So, you know, yeah. okay.
So we didn't get a mug, we didn't get a pen, we didn't get anything. We walked around, realized that there was really just one display of marathon specific gear, and it wasn't anything we were interested in. There was like a magic band, and
yeah,
we can use your Apple Watch now. So we didn't even use magic bands on this trip.
No.
And maybe some t-shirts. It was not anything worth spending money on. Yeah. So
we headed out.
And then we went to our hotel and crossed our fingers that the room would be ready, and it wasn't.
Yeah. So we walked around. We walked around the hotel for a bit, and it was nice.
And sat in the lobby for a bit.
Yeah, we did.
Okay.
We did.
Just waited for a little while.
So we just got back from the expo. We picked up our bib and shirts. And then we went to the merchandise. Yeah, there was nothing there. It was, you know, well, you'll see. Look at the footage. But we are thrilled because we had 2 hours of sleep. We got up at 2. We drove to the airport, we made our flight, it was delayed a little bit, no big deal. And we're here, and we are tired.
And our room's not ready.
I know. But we're here, we're in at the resort, and we're thrilled. It's been, you know, it's been really nice. This is the first time we have been here in 2 years, mm-hmm. and you know, we rented a car, and we navigated to the expo, and then here, so.
Yeah,
here we are. And then for Saturday, which would be a half marathon day,
yep.
We really wanted to support runners. And so if you've never done this, the way we kind of figured it out is you have to treat it like you're going to participate in that run.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. the even though we had our rental car, because it was run day with road closures and different parking scenarios and stuff, we decided let's just take a bus.
The race bus
to the start. So that's what we did, right? We took it to the start at Epcot.
And that's what you have to. Even if we had driven, we would have to go to Epcot to the start of the race to go anywhere else, take the monorail anywhere else to cheer on.
And then we made our way through, you know, the start area at Epcot to get to the Epcot monorail station.
Yes. And then we decided to cheer folks on at the TTC. Part of the reason that we chose that is because we really thought maybe it would be possible to walk there from our hotel. Yeah. We were staying at Wilderness Lodge, which is like a half a mile from the TTC, but we could not. There are no sidewalks. It's not ill-lit. It's not something they, I think, want pedestrians on or would have told
they don't us want if we'd you. Asked. They don't want you walking unless it's an absolute dedicated walk path. So even though we were half a mile away, we
came back. But it was, you know, as one does when you're standing around with a bunch of strangers, we, you know, chatted with the people to our left and chatted with the people to our right.
Yeah, really, really nice people. Mm-hmm. If you see this video, our pleasure meeting you. Really, really. It was so much fun. And if you want to cheer runners on, I think the TTC is a really good spot.
Yeah, sure.
Really good spot because look at this footage, right? We got there before the race started. The TTC is about between 3 and 4 miles from the start.
Yeah, it's like mile 3-ish.
And so we see the very first...
And like fresh-faced.
Yeah, it was
not
awesome.
Not people struggling towards the end. People still feeling really good. So
and
that
it
was
wasn't,
nice to cheer on.
You know, we weren't like fighting for a spot or anything. It was mm-hmm. really, really
it
nice.
It did fill up though by the time the race started.
Yeah, it did. Yeah. It did. So, you know, we were cheering people on. We got to see just so many... awesome people, so many cool costumes, mm-hmm. and we made friends, and you know that's kind of the best part about all of this, you know, just meeting people and getting to know people and cheering, you know, their friends on, our wonderful friend, you know, it was awesome. It was just so thrilling, and so you know that was really great. It was great, and then. You know, once we kind of got tired of saying, you know, go, go, go,
we would have loved to stay out all day and cheer everybody on as they passed, but we had a marathon to run the next day.
Yeah.
So we decided to like, you know, see Alistair. That's who we were there to cheer on. Mostly Jogger Vlogger, check him out. Awesome vlog.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Lovely to see you. Have a lovely day.
Yes, good luck.
See you at Epcot, 2 o'clock. Right. Yeah. Bring that. Yeah. Take care, guys.
If you want to get an awesome perspective on running, you need to check out Jogger Vlogger on YouTube. Alistair, you're awesome. It's
and it was so cool to see you run.
It was fantastic. The thing is, standing around for hours is not the best thing to do before you decide to run a marathon.
I think it might be okay, but it's probably not okay as we learned. We were more tired than we expected, but we'll cover that later.
We'll cover that. So we got back on, we got on the monorail to TTC.
Monorail back to Epcot. We sat for a very long time on a bus. So we had to basically wait for the race for folks to start finishing the race. Before they would pile up those buses. Yeah. So
we waited a while.
We waited quite a while.
But you know, the view from the monorail of the half marathoners, it is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just all of these people running. And I mean, you know, that's going to be us the next day, I'm saying. Yeah. But it is so awesome to see. Because it's not a perspective you see as a runner. I mean, you're just
running. We see the monorail go by. Yeah. You know, when we're doing those runs.
Yeah. But, that was really cool. And... I mean, it was great.
Yeah.
We got back eventually to our resort.
Mm-hmm.
Still kind of strung out because we hadn't quite slept what we needed to sleep.
We got a medium decent.
Yeah, it was all right. And then
we
laid out our stuff because it was going to be a down day. We prepared for the marathon.
And that was day 1 and 2 of our trip.
Yeah. That's right, Friday and Saturday, and leading up to the marathon. Our next video will be the marathon. We got a lot of really awesome footage. You might see yourself. So if you were there in some capacity.
And if you were, I don't know, starting group 6, there's a good chance we got
you. Yeah. So stick around. We'll have that video out in a week.
Take a
look at this one. Yeah. Once again, we cannot say this enough. so many people participated to make this happen. Mm-hmm. Volunteers. We can't just, it's not enough to say thank you, but that's what we're going to do. Because, I mean, without them, you know, we're talking about water stations, snack stations, the medical, the pacing groups. I mean, it is an enormous event to make happen, particularly now. And, you know, it's, well, they say magic happens there, right? That's pretty magical. And meeting so many people there and just, you know, kindred spirits, it's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. It's pretty exciting. I mean, we're back home and we're happy to be home, but so many great things happen, you know. You kind of want to still be there.
Yeah. Anyway. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's like I always say. Always an adventure with you. We hope you enjoy this part one, part two next week, and then part three the week after.
A recap.
Yeah. It was